Here we see a portrait of Napoleon's rowboat. And here is Napoleon's rowboat. This is the Museum of the Marine. And in addition to beautiful model ships, which my cousin's husband Ray used to rave over model ships. I wish he were here. But there's also Napoleon's rowboat. Ooh, look, here's the imperial crown. Wow. Yes, a big battle scene, the cannon thundering. And here are some people in rowboats going out to see the fleet. And some more model ships and a giant Napoleon. El gigante Napoleon. It's actually quite appropriate, this human towers over the history of France, and I am quite small compared to him. Yes, I am. There he is. In just one painting, there's an entire history of human character and life. What are these people doing with this cargo? Some of it is being carried away. Other parts of it are being piled up. Perhaps it will be loaded onto these ships. Why is that fire burning in the distance? What is that fire burning in the distance? And this one painting contains all of these little stories. And yet, it is not alone. There is another, and another, and another. And another, and another, and yet another, and yet another, and yet more, and more. What secrets are kept here in these historic cities? Who are these men looking out over the water? And who am I to question any of this, or to try to understand what people do when we look at art?
The harbors on the coast of France. and he asked Joseph Vernet to paint roughly 20 paintings of different roles of France. So he was very lucky. He had to go in different roles during 6 months, roughly, and to paint with a lot of precision the town, the sea, the ships, the rail ships, and to show even the new architecture as in Bordeaux, which was quite a new town at this time. So then they went. And there is one if you look at the collection. We have just a lack of two paintings, but we have all the collection if so. But he didn't like at all one of the drawings. It was the set. But you see that this one is different. You can see really the houses, and they are very well painted in Bordeaux. And he wrote a letter to the Marquess of Marigny, and he said that he didn't want to paint this port. And Marigny told him, you are paid a port. And so we had to do it. But you see that he represented a little storm. It's quite different from the other ones, which are really like maps or really. The most interesting, I think, are the two rooms of two. To have a good view of the painter of Marie, you have first to paint the sky to give the impression of the whiteness. And then, of course, he wanted all these collections not to be with monotony. It was difficult because they look like each other. So some of them are painted in the morning, like Rochefort, others in the evening, like La Rochelle or Toulon. And to interest people, we have in the first round here, first round, all the things that we have with a lot of details. If you come, because it's very little.
Sometimes, when you ask a question, you will get an answer. These weapons make me think of some comments that Frank and I exchanged the other day about the Greek armor. It seems swords have always been important, even on ships. Oh, look, here is the world, and there is my homeland, right in there. Continent is breaking apart. These models show how the great obelisk was brought from Egypt to stand in the Place Concorde. Was loaded onto a ship that had been hauled up onto the shore, and then the ship was drawn out to sea. Now I begin to feel familiar. These ships may be all French, but they are of my era, my time. The time of my parents and grandparents, the great wars, and the struggle for freedom against fascism. And then, we go back into the past again. What is this? A torpedo? Oh, look. The first battleships and the first torpedoes 100 years ago. And then back even further to the first steamships. Still had sails. It's said, when Napoleon heard of the invention of the steamship, that he said, "You would build a bonfire under the decks and tell me to throw away the sails? That's madness." But it happened. The steamship came to be. And here again is my homeland, unknown territory of California, the mythical island on the far side of the world, far away.